It all starts, stops here. This is the lab where Bosch tests each step of the process to make their brake pads. From tooling, mixing ingredients, pressing, baking, grinding, and more. The formulas are tested and perfected here before making their way to the larger production facilities to be made at scale. OE pads are scanned as a baseline to work off of, measuring down to the micron level, which ensures brake pads are a direct OE replacement. One of the many ways a brake pad starts its life is running a dimensional check to ensure the brake pad is exactly the right shape and size. After scanning, CAD is used to create their in-house pad tooling. Once approval of the tooling has been completed, the team goes into compound testing. This process is a lot like creating a cake recipe. It first starts with measuring out specific amounts of four primary raw materials amongst many others to reach the desired performance: graphite, aramid fibers, colemanite, and alumina, each responsible for a completely different parameter within the compound blend. Once the ratios of raw materials are accurately measured out, it's time to mix them into one blend. This machine is like an oversized stand mixer, using large metal blades to combine the materials into what will become the pad composition. After the mixing is complete, it's emptied out into a bag, and then enough of the mixture for each pad separately gets measured out before the next step of the process. Each blend has a specific target weight, depending on the compound type, pad, shape, size, and application. Once measured out, it's time to fill in the earlier engineering tooling with the specified compound mixture. After pouring the mixture, the backing plate for the pad is put on top to seal the mold, which will then be pressed together into the actual pad formation. Bosch utilizes positive mold press technology, and this ensures proper adherence to the backing plate as well as accurate density throughout the pad, allowing for even wear and performance. Once the bonding process is complete, the pad is then visually inspected for any discrepancies. And after passing its initial quality check, the pads are then placed in a cooling basket before making their way over to the final step of the curing process, the oven. Here, it's cured at a high temperature for an extended amount of time, which burns out resins and gases so that it is ready for use right out of the box. Once the pad is cured, it still needs to take its final form. Using the initial CAD file, the desired shape requires chamfers and cuts to achieve a one-to-one match with the OE pad designed for its caliper and rotor combination. For this, diamond blades on a CNC machine are used, ensuring as accurate of cuts as possible. Grinding slots and chamfers allows Bosch to control the material density, resulting in better quietness characteristics. You can see on the bottom what a pad looks like prior to entering the finishing machine and after on top. A finished pad still needs to be run through quality testing, and with this being the R&D lab, every single pad produced here is run through a myriad of final checks and tests so that engineers are able to look for any production inconsistencies. This is where they test brake pad compressibility, basically how much the material flexes under pressure. Too soft and you lose pedal feel. Too firm and you risk noise and harshness. Bosch tunes this precisely to balance comfort and control across every batch. Next, they shear the friction material off the backing plate to stress test the bond. It's extreme, but it proves the pad won't fail under real-world braking. They're checking for even adhesive coverage, because safety starts with consistency. Dust, noise, and wear matter, but nothing comes before stopping power. Once a compound has been perfected, it's time for large-scale production, and finally making its way onto one of our customers' cars. Whether it's for your sports car, SUV, or daily driver, shop Bosch Brakes and more at fcpeuro.com.